Welcome students, here we are going to discuss the part 2 of climate of India. Seasons of India. Generally we have 4 seasons. They are hot and dry season, southwest monsoon season, retreating monsoon season and cold season or winter.
Let us discuss hot and dry season. It prevails from the month of March to May. Now what are the characteristics of this hot season? The season is marked by dry weather and extreme heat. Okay, the season is marked by dry weather and extreme heat. Dry weather because hardly we get any rainfall in the month of March and May. Okay, hardly we get any rainfall in the month of March and May. That is why we have a dry weather and extreme heat. In this season, sun is directly over the Tropic of Cancer. Okay, remember that in this season, the sun is directly over the Tropic of Cancer. Extreme low pressure condition is created over the Indian landmass. Okay, extreme low pressure condition is created over Indian landmass. Okay, now what happens here during summer? So before telling that, always remember that temperature and pressure, it is inversely related. Okay, when temperature increases, pressure decreases. When temperature decreases, pressure increases. Okay. Now, what I was saying, during summer season, our land surface experiences high temperature. Okay. That's why the pressure in the northern, especially in the northern part of India, becomes very, very low. Okay. Now, on 21st of June, okay, on 21st of June, what happened? The sun starts its northward movement. On 21st June, the sun starts its northward movement. From the southern part of India, from the south, it moves towards the north. So when it moves towards the north, it is directly over Tropic of Cancer. Now when the sun is directly over the Tropic of Cancer, the next topic is southwest monsoon or monsoonal season, or you can say it rainy season, which is from the month of June to September. Now in monsoonal season, due to intense heat during summer, a very high pressure difference is created. The very high pressure difference is created between the Indian landmass and the water bodies. Now, this attract the winds blowing in the southern hemisphere. It attracts the wind blowing in the southern hemisphere. Now these winds, after crossing the equator, this wind which is blowing in the southern hemisphere after crossing the equator, get deflected towards India as southwest monsoon wind. Okay. Now, let me tell you in details. By the end of May, what happened? Due to the differential heating of land and sea, brings about a seasonal low pressure trough. Okay, brings about a seasonal low pressure area in this region. Look at the cursor. A seasonal low pressure region in this area. Okay, from Thar Desert to Chotanagpur Plateau region. Now, as a result, a high pressure gradient builds up between hot North India with intense low pressure and cooler water bodies surrounding it with high pressure. Now due to this, what happened? Here, a very low pressure is generated and over the water bodies, there is high pressure. So generally we know that wind moves from high pressure to low pressure region. Okay, now what this low pressure do? The low pressure which is generated in the northern part of India, this low pressure attracts the southeast trade wind. Okay, it attracts the southeast trade wind blowing in from the southern hemisphere. The southeast trade wind means the southeast trade wind is coming from this in this direction. Okay, from the southern hemisphere, this southeast trade wind is attracted by the low pressure generated in the Indian landmass. As such, after crossing the equator, this southeast trade wind, it get deflected towards India. It get deflected towards Indian subcontinent as southwest monsoon wind. Okay, southwest monsoon wind. So while moving towards India, this southwest monsoon wind, it picks up moisture from the Arabian Sea. It picks up moisture from the Arabian Sea. They are named as southwest monsoon. As they blow from southwest to northeast, the advance of southwest monsoon can be the next topic is southwest monsoon. Or you can say it rainy season. Now, what is happening during the southwest monsoonal season? A very low pressure is generated over the Indian landmass in the northern part, and high pressure is generated in the water bodies in Bay of Bengal region and Arabian Sea region. Now, this low pressure, okay, this low pressure area, which is generated in between Thar Desert and Chotanagpur Plateau, this low pressure region attracts the southeast trade wind, attracts the southeast trade wind, which is coming from the southern hemisphere. In this direction, from this direction, southeast trade wind comes from the southern hemisphere. So when this southeast trade wind crosses the equator, when it crosses the equator, this southeast trade wind gets deflected towards the Indian subcontinent. What? This southeast trade wind get deflected towards the Indian subcontinent because of the low pressure generated in Indian landmass. Now, this southeast trade wind, when it get deflected towards the Indian subcontinent, it picks up a lot of moisture from the Arabian Sea. It picks up a lot of moisture from the Arabian Sea, and they are named as southwest monsoon wind. Okay, they're named as southwest monsoon wind. Let me tell you again, during this southwest monsoonal season, a low pressure trough is generated over the Indian landmass from the Thar Desert and Chotanagpur Plateau, whereas a high pressure develops over the water bodies, Arabian Sea and Bay of Bengal. Now, the low pressure that is generated over the Indian landmass, it attracts the wind. Okay, which wind? The southeast trade wind blowing from southern hemisphere. Okay, the southeast trade wind blowing from southern hemisphere. Now, the southeast trade wind, due to the attraction of the low pressure, what it happens when the southeast trade wind crosses the equator, it gets deflected towards the Indian subcontinent. Okay, the southeast trade wind gets deflected towards the Indian subcontinent because of the pull of the low pressure, and it picks up a lot of moisture from Arabian Sea. Okay, this southeast trade wind, it picks up a lot of moisture from the Arabian Sea, and after crossing the equator, the southeast trade wind, when it gets deflected towards India, it is named as southwest monsoonal wind. Now, Malabar coast in Kerala. Okay, Malabar coast in Kerala is the first location to receive monsoonal rainfall in India. Okay, so this is Kerala. Okay, this place is Kerala. This western coastal region, this is Kerala. So this place over here is Malabar coast. So this is the place where I put the cursor. This is the place where the first monsoonal wind strikes and causes heavy rainfall over Kerala. Next, now the southeast monsoon or southeast monsoon can be divided into two branches: Arabian Sea branch and Bay of Bengal branch. Okay, what are the two branches? Arabian Sea branch and Bay of Bengal branch. Now, Arabian Sea branch, it hits the Malabar coast in Kerala, causing heavy rainfall in the windward side of the western coast. Now, I told you earlier that the monsoon first hits Kerala in Malabar coast area. Okay, this is the place, the first place to receive the monsoonal rain. This is located in the windward side of the western ghat. Malabar coast is located in the windward side of the western ghats. Remember that, windward side of the western ghats. Now, what is windward side or leeward side. Okay, so this black line, okay, this black line is western Ghats. Okay, so when the monsoonal wind will come and hit, first it will hit in this side, in the western side of the western Ghats. So the western side of the western Ghats are called windward side, the side where the wind hits. Okay, and the eastern side of the western Ghats means these regions of western Ghats are called leeward side or rain shadow region, which receives very less rainfall. Okay, the side of the mountain where the wind hits is called the windward side, and the back side of the mountain is called the leeward side or rain shadow region. The leeward side rain shadow of western Ghats receives less rain. Now, so for example, Mahabaleshwar, situated on the western side of western Ghats, receives more rainfall. Okay, whereas Pune receives less rainfall. But Mahabaleshwar, situated in the western side of the western Ghats, receives more rainfall compared to Pune. Mahabaleshwar, which is situated in the windward side, gets rainfall of 250 centimeters annually, 250 centimeters, whereas Pune is situated on the leeward side of the western Ghat. Pune is situated in the leeward side of the western Ghat. That is why it receives less rainfall, nearly 70 centimeters of rainfall annually. Now, the region of Rajasthan and Thar Desert do not receive any rainfall from Arabian Sea branch. What? The region of Rajasthan and Thar Desert means this region. Okay, this region doesn't receive any rainfall from Arabian Sea branch. Why? Because of the location of mountain, because of the location of hills. Now, this black line, what is it? It is Aravalli Range. Okay, this is our Aravalli Range. So, this Aravalli Range, just look at its location. It is parallel to the southwest monsoon wind. This is what? Parallel to the southwest monsoon wind. So that's why the wind is not obstructed by this mountain. That is why there is no rainfall in Rajasthan. Now just think, now this is, the mountain is parallel to the monsoonal wind. Now if it is horizontal to the monsoonal wind, then what could happen? The wind could have hit the mountain, and this place, Rajasthan, could have got rain. But there could have been rainfall in Rajasthan. As this mountain, Aravalli Range, is parallel to the southwest monsoon wind, that is why it doesn't receive, this region of Thar Desert or Rajasthan doesn't receive any rainfall. Now, the heat of the desert. Okay, the heat of the desert helps to increase the capacity of wind to hold more moisture. Now, why there is no rainfall in Rajasthan? Another reason is because of the heat of the desert. Now, the heat of the desert, it helps the southwest monsoon wind to increase its capacity to hold more and more moisture. The heat of the desert helps southwest monsoonal wind to hold more and more moisture. Now, if the wind can hold more and more moisture, why should the wind shed moisture? Okay, why should be there rainfall? There should be, as the wind can hold more and more moisture, why should the wind shed its water? That is why there is no rainfall in this region. Mainly two reasons. One is the location of Aravalli Range. Another reason is the heat of the deserts. Now, Arabian Sea branch is much more powerful than Bay of Bengal branch. Why is it so? Because Arabian Sea branch is more bigger. Okay, it's more bigger than the Bay of Bengal branch. That is why it is more powerful. That's why Arabian Sea branch is more powerful compared to Bay of Bengal branch. Now let us see Bay of Bengal branch. Andaman and Nicobar Islands are the first to receive rainfall from Bay of Bengal branch. The first place which received rainfall from Bay of Bengal branch is Andaman and Nicobar Island. A part of Bay of Bengal,
it is not Bai, it will be Bay. Part of Bay of Bengal branch is intercepted by Garo Khasi and Garo Khasi and Jayantia Hills. Now, this Bay of Bengal branch, one branch it enters through this side, okay. Another branch it enters through Northeast India. Now, when it enters Northeast India, in this area, remember, look at the cursor. In this area, there is a mountain range. Okay, Garo, Khasi, and Jayantia Hills. Garo Hills, Khasi Hill, and Jayantia Hill. So the wind is obstructed there, and it causes heavy rainfall over that place. While Shillong is located beyond the Garo Khasi and Jayantia Hill. That's why it receives less rainfall. Now, Mosindram near Cherrapunji is the place which receives the highest amount of annual rainfall throughout the world. So Mosindram near Cherrapunji is the place which receives the highest amount of rainfall throughout the year. Now, where is it located or where is it situated? It is situated here, okay, in this place. Now, Mosindram near Cherrapunji stands at the end of a funnel-shaped valley. Okay, Mosindram is located in a valley. The shape of the valley is funnel shaped. Okay, which act as a trap for Bay of Bengal. Now, this funnel shaped valley it traps Bay of Bengal branch. That's why it receives much more rainfall, or that is why it is the highest annual rainfall place in the world. Now look at here what I told you, funnel shaped valley. So this is a valley, this is a funnel shaped valley. Okay. And this green dot is Cherrapunji located here. Okay. Now when the Bay of Bengal branch enters this place, okay, it has the wind affects it from three directions. One is straight, one from the left hand side, another from the right hand side. From three directions, it gets the wind, and due to this, it gets heavy rainfall in Cherrapunji, and that is why it is called the highest rainfall area in the world. And finally, it merges with the Arabian Sea. Finally, Bay of Bengal branch merges with Arabian Sea branch and shed the remaining moisture at the foothills of Himalayas. But at the end, Arabian Sea branch shed the remaining moisture at the foothill of the Himalayan region.
Thank you.